Good morning, State Line. A complete different story today as compared to yesterday. Look at all the damage yesterday as a line of showers and storms move through the area. Some of those storms were strong to severe. The National Weather Service yesterday was issuing severe thunderstorm watches for the entire viewing area, and then some severe thunderstorm warnings and a few tornado warnings throughout portions of the area as these strong storms moved through the area, caused a lot of damage on their way through. Quick mover, though. They moved through the area at nearly 45 to 50 miles an hour, left a lot of wind damage, heavy rain throughout the area. But it's going to be some nice weather today to start the cleanup process after all that damage from yesterday. But take a look at some of these storm reports that we got yesterday. You can see started all the way back out over central and eastern Iowa, and actually the National Weather Service sent their survey crew out, and they did confirm a brief tornado near Mechanicsville in Iowa, and it damaged some grain bins and caused some damage to some cornfields as well. But then as it made its way towards us, you can see a lot of wind damage, and that continued over central portions of Indiana and western portions of Michigan, right along Lake Michigan there. But for us locally, two lines here that we're focusing on that affected started in Carroll and Whiteside counties and worked their way through Ogle and Lee and parts of DeKalb counties, bringing a lot of wind damage throughout the area. And those were the two storms and the two lines throughout that line of storms that the National Weather Service was mainly focused on, because there was a lot of strong winds in there and a little bit of rotation as it made its way through that caused all that damage throughout the area yesterday. But our weather headlines, topping them off, is the complete 180 difference from yesterday to today. Today, well below average temperature-wise. We actually hit the low 80s yesterday. We'll be in the mid-60s this afternoon. High pressure builds in behind that cold front, keeping us dry today and cool. And we do run the risk of a potential frost going into the late hours of Friday and early Saturday if we get cool enough and we stay dry Friday night and into Saturday. It's going to get cool out there. Temperatures going down into the 30s. Take a look at our Mercy Health SkyCam here overlooking the Poplar Grove Airport. Few passing clouds throughout the area, but we're going to see some sunshine today, especially throughout the early part of the day, increasing clouds later on. Temperatures right now in the mid 40s with a westerly wind at 7 miles an hour. We're starting off in the low and mid 40s throughout the viewing area. We'll warm it up into the low and mid 60s this afternoon. Cooler air thanks to this cold front pushing off to our east, bringing still some strong storms to the northeast today, but you can see it well defined here on our temperature map. In front of it, 60s and 70s. Behind it, the 40s and 50s, but high pressure circulating off to our west will help to keep us high and dry today. You can see the cooler air that's funneling down on in, not only for today, but it'll go into your day tomorrow, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, well below average before we start to warm it back up early next week. Low 80s yesterday, down into the upper 40s last night, and a noticeable change. Highs today right around 64 degrees. Like I mentioned, our average first freeze potentially will be coming up. We could fall into the 30s depending on some cloud cover late Friday and into Saturday. It usually occurs around the 1st to the 10th of October, and the first hard freeze when we get temperatures down into the upper 20s, not until the middle of October. Futurecast mapping it out. Not much of anything today, just a few passing clouds. Otherwise, sunny skies will keep the clear skies around tonight. Temperatures falling down thanks to those clear skies into the mid 40s. Some clouds build in late tomorrow. Isolated passing shower can't be ruled out, especially through the late evening hours and into the early morning hours of your Friday. Mapping it out today for you, warming it up, 64 degrees, a few passing clouds, otherwise breezy. Tonight, cooling it down into the mid-40s, cool overnight tonight. Take a look at tomorrow's forecast. Another cool one, highs topping out in the upper 60s, increasing clouds, a passing shower cannot be ruled out, especially late afternoon and evening hours. 7-day forecast, take a look at those temperatures. Upper 50s by Saturday. We're going to have a hard time breaking 60. Overnight lows Friday into Saturday, 39. Some models are pointing a little bit cooler. That's why I had to throw in the potential first freeze there into the forecast.
Oh, gosh, Ryan. I thought you were putting in a note to Mother Nature for me.
I'm sorry. She didn't listen.
Oh, yeah. She generally doesn't. But
she's not very friendly to me. I'll keep trying, though.
All right. Thanks, Ryan.